Welcome to our course, Excel Fundamentals, Formulas for Finance. It can be a little bit overwhelming in Excel sometimes because there are literally hundreds, if not thousands, formulas and functions in the software, and it's hard to know which ones are the best ones to use within the finance profession. So this course effectively filters and sorts through all of those formulas and functions to focus you on the ones that are the most important for financial analysis. So in this video, we're going to take a look at the XLOOKUP function, and it's really better than the HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP in every way. First of all, the single XLOOKUP function replaces both of those functions, and also it's not prone to errors that can get caused by users inserting rows or columns. Overall, it's a better function, and you're going to see it's much more simple. Let's jump in and take a look at how it works. So in this area where it says XLOOKUP 1, we're going to look at how the XLOOKUP function can work in a horizontal fashion. So let's pop into this cell and type equals XL. Right away, the function name comes up. We can hit the tab key. Now the lookup value, which is the first argument, is going to be the same. We're just going to select item number 4, put in a comma. Well, now it's looking specifically for the lookup array. So where should it look for item number 4? Well, we're going to select right here, all the way across, just to include these item numbers. Now we put in a comma, and now it's asking for the return array. And we're going to select one row right here where all the commissions can be found. What we can do now is just close the bracket and hit enter. So now let's build up an XLOOKUP function down here in a vertical fashion. So we're going to hit equals XL, function name comes up, hit the tab key. The lookup value is going to be here, item number 4. Let's put in a comma. For the lookup array, we're going to select all the way down here vertically, and then we're going to put in a comma. And for the return array, we're going to select these commissions that are from here all the way down to here. Then we can close the bracket and hit enter. As we mentioned earlier, the entire library of functions available in Excel can be very overwhelming. This course will save you immense amounts of time by helping you sift through, focus only on the functions which are the most effective within the finance industry. There's lots to cover, so let's get in there and get started.